there, I'm glad you're here. My name is Chris, and this is the Sons of Sever YouTube channel, where there's no such thing as bad weather, only bad gear. Today, we are finally delving into a category of gear that we're very excited to talk to you about, and that is stand-up paddle boards. The offering that we have for you today is from a company called Freein. Just up front, they sent this board out for us to create content with the board, tag them in videos of us using it, which if you follow our Instagram, then you would have seen it already. And for this review and eventually some comparison with some other paddle boards that have been sent to us as well. So I really like this product, just to tell you up front. Now, I am newer to paddleboarding, so you get kind of the perspective of a beginner, and then with Eric, somebody who is way more familiar with paddleboards than I am. On that note, I have been on several paddleboards. I've just never owned one, and I've never been on one consistently long enough to give an opinion about it, except for now this one from Freein. I actually have their website pulled up, and we're gonna start off by just going over some of the specs of the paddle boards. The first thing is the name. It is the Freein 10-6 Inflatable Kayak SUP 2023. So that's going to tell you right there that it kind of goes into two categories. It's a stand-up paddleboard, but it can also be used as a kayak, which you will see in a second here. I want to talk about the different color options that they have. So the one that we have that you will see throughout the video is in the aqua colorway. So that colorway is kind of a teal and a red with some black on it. Then they have an orange, a blue, and a red as well. Now, something I just need to point out as I'm here on the website is that usually this paddleboard retails for about $470. Right now, it's on sale for $299, and it has been since we got it about a month and a half, 2 months ago. So if you're looking for an opportunity to get into the paddleboard game more affordably, now would be the time, and Freein would be a great option for you to look into. Again, that's the opinion of a beginner paddleboarder, but I think this board has everything that you need in order to get started, and we're going to talk about that. Go ahead and check out the link down in the description if you are interested in checking out the Freein board specifically. That link will take you straight over to their website, and you can use Sons of Sever as a discount code at checkout, and that'll save you 10%. I think that works on top of what you're already saving just from shopping with them. Now I want to get into some of the more specific specs of the board. So as we said, it is 10'6". It's in the title, it's in the name of the board. The board's width is 31", which is wide enough, as I will say, as a beginner. The board thickness is 6", which I think is relatively common with most inflatable paddle boards. The weight is 18.7 pounds, so one person should be able to carry this relatively comfortable from the beach into the water, which is really nice. The weight limit is 286 pounds. It says that the optimal person's is one, but that's optimal. If you want to go out and have fun with somebody else on the board, I think it's gonna work out unless it's you and your jacked friend. That might be a little bit more tough. The pump is a double action hand pump, and it's 25". The optimal inflation is 12 to 14 PSI, if that matters to you. The paddle that it comes with is convertible from 5'3 to 7'3, and it's 3 pounds. The fins, there are three of them, and one of them, the big one, is detachable, which is nice for when you're rolling it up to put it away. And then the travel bag that it comes in is 37 by 18 by 10", and it carries everything just fine. Now I want to get into the included items. I think this is important because there are some paddle boards out there where when you buy it, it's really just the board. Some of them don't come with paddles and all the accoutrements that you need in order to go and get out on the water today. So the included items list, obviously, the kayak paddleboard, the travel backpack, the detachable kayak seat, which is very nice that you don't have to go out and buy one, the double action hand pump, which we've already talked about, the convertible paddle. So it's convertible because it can have a handle on one side and the paddle on the other, or it could have a paddle on both sides so that you really can kayak with it. Kind of cool. It has that removable fin that we talked about, a 10-inch coiled leash for your ankle so that it keeps the board close to you even if you fall off of it. It comes with a pump adapter, and it comes with a repair kit. So, really, this thing comes to you in a box, you open it up, it's all rolled up in the travel bag, you pull it out, unroll it, pump it up, and you are good to go out on the water that day. No need to go find a paddle, find a leash, find a pump, or anything like that. It all comes and you're ready to go right out of the box. Now that we've got that out of the way, I'm gonna send things over to Eric so that he can talk about his experience with the board so far.
So my overall experience with the board so far has been pretty positive. There's a few things that I really like about it and then a few things not so much. I really like all the accessories that come with the board and the price point that it sits at. So the boards out there that come with kayak conversion kits are usually a little bit higher in price. Obviously they come with more things, but this one sits at a pretty affordable price. So I really like that. I really like how small the thing can pack down. So I was really surprised actually when the box got sent to us, and it was a pretty good size box. And I was like, yeah, that makes sense. There's a lot of things, but then we opened it and inside was another smaller box and there was nothing else in there. And I was like, oh man, all of this fits into that. That's really impressive. So for coming with all of the things to convert it into a kayak and to have it all fit inside the backpack, I really like that too. I like the removable center fin. So that isn't a feature on all paddle boards. Like if you're going to go to Costco and buy the board that's there, that's the one that I have. It's got these three little fixed fins and it doesn't track very straight because of that. But this Freein board has this really big center fin. It helps the board to track straight when you're out there. And the fact that you can remove it means that you can roll it up really, really small, which helps to be able to fit everything into the included backpack. I do like that you can fit everything that you need into the bag. You'd be able to take it on a small hike up to a secluded lake and have everything that you want to either use it as a stand-up paddleboard or as a sit-on-top kayak. I think that's something that's really cool about it. My main dislike of the board is the paddle. With my experience so far, it was really difficult to figure out which side you were supposed to hold it on, because there is a specific way that the blade is supposed to go into the water. But once I figured out, how the grip was up at the top of the paddle, then I was like, okay, this is the right way, but I go in and I don't feel like the blade does well when it's in the water. I don't feel like I'm getting a lot of return for the effort that I'm putting in. It just feels awkward. It just doesn't feel like it's catching the water the way that it's supposed to. Now, I imagine that this might have something to do with the fact that it needs to double, right, as a kayak paddle and a stand-up paddleboard paddle, and they are a little bit different. So for it to be in the middle ground like that, I think kind of makes sense. But if this was going to be my go-to paddleboard and I wanted to use it for stand-up paddling, I would definitely go out and buy a different paddle that works a lot better than the one that gets sent. I do think that this board is stable enough, but there are definitely more stable boards out there. So this one's only 31 inches wide at its widest point. And all around boards that are for beginners often sit around like 34 to 35 inches. So this one is a little bit narrower there. I think that somebody who has a bigger build or somebody who's not athletically inclined might struggle just a little bit to get on the board and find their balance. But anybody who has a smaller frame, anybody who is athletically inclined, I think it's gonna do just fine for it. Like Chris hasn't had any problem. He hasn't fallen off of it yet. So it is stable, but I do think that there are other options out there that would be more stable.
So my experience with the board has been very interesting as more of a beginner or less experienced paddle boarder. I really don't know any different. So I have enjoyed the board so far. I like the sense of freedom that it gives me out on the water. It's really cool to be able to drive to the beachfront, which is only 2 minutes away from my house, and launch that board and then just be out and away from everything and out on the water. I start to feel a little bit like a pirate, or like I could do anything and go anywhere and do whatever I want, which is definitely not reality, but the board facilitates that and it does a really good job in my opinion of that. Now, is it the perfect board? No. And we will talk about that in a second with our rating system, and we will probably get into that in future videos when it comes to comparisons. But there are some things that I think the board does really well, especially for the price price point that it's at. So getting into the way that we rate products, if you're new to the channel, every product that comes through here is going to get a rating of 1 to 10 in three categories, and those are function, feel, and versatility. And then we're going to average those up to give you a final product score at the end of the video. I'm going to pass it over to Eric to start that conversation. Before though, he is going to talk to you about some affiliates.
Before getting into the rating system, we did want to mention some of the affiliates that we have associated with the channel now. Freein is an affiliate, so the paddle board that we're reviewing today. If you are looking to get out onto the water this summer, then we would highly suggest using that link, going to their website, and if you are going to buy anything, then you can use Sons of Sever as a discount code at checkout. So that's all in the description. We really like the board that they sent us. It's been a lot of fun, and we think that it's really good quality as well at a great price point. If you're looking for sunglasses, we have a link to the Ombraz website, which is a different type of sunglass. It doesn't have sidearms. In my opinion, they're extremely comfortable because of that. They stick to your face. So again, if you're looking to get on the water and you don't want to worry about losing your sunglasses, go check out Ombraz. They have this cord that wraps around your head, and I've been wearing them for about 3 years. I really love them. All right, when it comes to the function of the board, I think we want to keep in mind what it's built for, right? It's a stand-up paddleboard. In this case, an inflatable stand-up paddleboard. So it's meant to inflate stiff enough that you can get out on the water and have no issues paddling around. And I think that it does a pretty good job at doing that. So if you get it up to that recommended 15 PSI, you're gonna have no issues with the stiffness of the board. I know that when people come into paddleboarding and they hear about inflatable ones, it's like, oh, is that gonna be a stiff enough surface for me to stand on with no issues? And it totally is. Get it up to that recommended 15 PSI and you're gonna be just fine. I think that the pump that comes with it functions very standard as far as the industry goes. It has two different modes on, oh, this one actually has three different modes on it. So when you start initially pumping, it's gonna pump air on the up and the downstroke, which is really nice. And then when that gets too hard, you pull out this little plug and that makes it so that it only puts air in on the downstroke. So you can finish off the inflation process at that point. But then it also has a deflate setting, which I haven't seen on any pumps before. So that's really nice. You can pull as much air out of the board as possible so that it can pack down even smaller. So that all functions super well. I think that the accessories that come with it work well too. The kayak seat is comfortable. You can adjust it in different ways. There's a bunch of different D-rings on the top of the board. It's comfortable to sit on there and it's really nice. And I also like the paddle in the kayak mode so you can put the other blade onto that side and that all works just fine for being a kayak. But again, when it comes to the function of the paddle, I don't think it does well as a stand-up paddle. It just was awkward to try and figure out which way to put into the water, and then when I decided what the right way was, it just doesn't feel that good when the blade goes in. Because of the lack of functionality from the paddle, and because of how important that is, we decided to give it a 7 out of 10 on the function. So now I'm gonna send it back over to Chris so that he can talk about the feel of the board.
So talking about the feel of this board, I think is a very important conversation because you want this thing to be comfortable. Odds are good you're gonna be in water shoes, which are very thin, or barefoot on this thing. So the material that it's made out of, the fact that it is grippy but not abrasive, is very important. And I think that this board meets that balance. It's a very comfortable board. It's very soft, but it's also sturdy. It doesn't feel weak, but it feels comfortable. It's definitely comfortable enough to sit on and lay down on. Eric and I actually sit on these boards a lot in order to set up drone shots and do stuff like that. But it is definitely not abrasive, jagged, sharp, or uncomfortable in any way, shape, or form. And I think that's all you can ask for the board at the end of the day. Now, the other aspect of feel that I want to talk about is how I feel when I'm on the board. I think the board lends itself very well to being stable for the less experienced paddleboarder. I have never at any point on this board felt too crazy unstable, like I was gonna lose control and fall. Spoiler alert, I did not fall in the whole time that we were filming content for this, which is important because we carry all of our drone equipment in those chest packs with us, so a fall would be somewhat catastrophic. But I've felt stable from day one, and on day one I kayaked around on it first with the seat, and then I stood up for about 5 minutes to give it a whirl, and I haven't looked back since. I've been standing up on that paddleboard ever since that first day, and it's been super fun, super easy to get used to, and it feels really, really good. For all those reasons, we've decided to give it a score of 7 when it comes to feel. Now I'm gonna pass things back over to Eric so that he can give his opinion on the versatility.
All right, when it comes to the function of the board, it's going to be a little bit of a different conversation than we're used to having with things like our shoes or our backpacks, because a paddleboard is built for one specific thing, right? And that's to get you out onto the water. But within that realm, there's a few different subsets of ways that people use paddleboards. So on one end of the spectrum, you have, you know, boards that are built for stability, and people go out and do yoga on the board. And then on the other end of the spectrum, you've got something that's strictly built for speed. So the stability isn't really what they're looking at, it's just looking to move and cut through the water as fast as possible for racing or for touring. And then you've got the stuff in the middle. And with a 10-foot, 6-inch board, that's typically the middle ground. That's trying to be an all-around board. And this one, I think, does that, but it leans a little bit more towards trying to be on the performance side because it's so thin. It's at 31 inches across. But I don't feel like it does that very well, especially with the way that the paddle performs. I feel like if you were gonna try and take this thing touring, it would be quite the slog. If you were gonna take this on a long paddle, like you wanted to load it up with gear and you wanted to just head out across the lake, I think that it would be pretty tough. It only has the one set of bungees, so you can't really put that much gear onto it. And then I just don't think that it performs super well as far as speed goes. I think that you're gonna get tired pretty fast out there paddling for miles and miles. But then it also doesn't lend itself super well on the yoga or the stability side of things because it's only 31 inches. Like, it's gonna be totally fine if you're out just having a nice day on calm water with your friends and you guys are out just having fun. But if you wanna go out and try and do yoga on it, I think that you're gonna end up in the water quite a bit trying to do those poses because it's just not wide enough to give you that stability. So for those reasons, we gave it a 6 out of 10 for the versatility. All right, so now I'm gonna send it back over to Chris to give you the final score and the wrap up.
So the final product score that we are going to give the Freein Kayak stand-up paddleboard is a 6.5 out of 10. I think it deserves it. I think that it sits itself very well in the middle of the pack when it comes to boards in general. And considering how affordable it is, I think that's right where it belongs. This board is going to be great for a less experienced paddleboarder, but I think it can also be enjoyable for the experienced paddleboarder. This board kind of sits in the category for me of jack of all trades, master of none. There's no one thing that paddleboards do super duper well that this excels at, but it does all the things that it needs to do. It comes with all the equipment that you need in order to get out there for the first time, and I think it makes the barrier to entry very, very low. If you liked this video or you found it helpful in your paddleboard journey, we would appreciate it if you would like and subscribe. We've got a lot of other really cool paddleboard content coming down the pipeline. There are lots of places to follow along with us. You can come over to our Instagram where we are posting about new products that we're working with daily. You can also follow along on Strava to see our activity and track your activity alongside us. Eric has his own YouTube channel called A Pilot's Life for Me that focuses on really cool landscape drone videography. I have my own YouTube channel and Instagram page called Sever Shoots that focuses on gun industry, outdoor, and preparedness gear. We appreciate your view, and as always, we will catch you in the mountains, or maybe for this one, out on the water.